Well, the Discover Historic New England series continues at the Thomas Crane Public Library this month on Tuesday, May 8th from 7 to 8:30 p.m. It is the history of pie, in particular, New England pie, History Under a Crust by Robert Cox, who is joining us here via Skype to tell us a little bit more about himself and about this particular project. So, Mr. Cox, great to meet you and chat with you. And this, I mean, it's pie, so it's a fun topic, right?
Can't go wrong. Can't go wrong.
Tell us a little bit about yourself, if you could. First of all, your background, your education, and any of the work that you have up to this point.
Mm-hmm. Well, background-wise, it's diverse and unsavory. I was a paleontologist for a long time, a molecular biologist for a bit, and then I shifted over to history and archives. And I've been in Massachusetts for about 14, 15 years now as head of special collections at UMass. And as a historian, I've worked on a variety of topics, starting with the American Spiritualist Movement, speaking to the dead in the 19th century, a little bit on Lewis and Clark, and then the last three books have been on New England cuisine.
Oh, okay. Where are you from originally? What's your original educational background?
That's probably the hardest question to ask.
Leave it to me, right?
I'm from every state that begins with a C, but I grew up mostly in California and went to high school in Colorado, Connecticut, a bunch of other places. But I've lived in Michigan, where I got my PhD in history and also my MLS in archives, and undergrad work at Haverford College in Pennsylvania. So,
okay, what was it originally that drew you here to New England, to Massachusetts? How did that journey happen?
Well, I've worked as an archivist for a few years and was in a position to, you know, think about looking for a good position for somebody who wanted to grow into a new archive or a different archive anyway. And the job opened up. I've been fascinated with New England since I was a little kid. We were probably one of the few families on the West Coast to subscribe to Yankee Magazine as a little kid. But, you know, we saw the job opening up, and I decided this would be something I should apply for. I came up here. I liked the director. I liked the people I work with. And it seemed like a great opportunity to make the collection grow. So that's what we've done.
Okay, so tell us about this particular work, New England Pie, History Under a Crust. How did this come about?
Well, it's part of a trilogy of books on New England foods, and it began because we have been accumulating a massive collection of cookbooks relating to New England at UMass here for a number of years now. And most of our cookbooks, not quite all of them, but most of them are cookbooks that are put out by community groups, churches, women's organizations, things like that. And we have probably somewhere in the range of 12, 15,000 of these things now. And I had a student a few years ago who was interested in doing a project on New England foods. And we settled on the idea of working on chowder. And we did a website called The Compendium of Chowder, which I think may actually still be live. I'm not sure. But The Compendium of Chowder was just a collection of huge numbers of historic recipes for chowder. A publisher saw it and said, do you want to do a book? And we decided that if we're going to do one, I might as well do three. And it started with chowder, went on to do a book on cranberry, and pie was the third leg of that book that came out of thin air one day in a conversation with the publisher, just said, hey, let's work on pie. And I eat quite well, thank you.
So let me ask you then, you know, point blank, what is the history of pie in New England? How does it date back to?
Well, you know, pie is one of those things that has, in New England at least, very deep British roots. We settled here by Brits in the 17th century, it was 1630, 1620, 1650, whatever, depending on where you're looking. New England settlers who came from England brought with them a love of pie, and they had a love both of sweet pie and savory pie. Mm. And pie may have spread nationally, but New England is one of the places where we still see this dichotomy between the love of sweet and savory, both in the same region. And we have had this great love affair with pie ever since. Certain pies more than others, but pie has been part of the table in New England from the first settling of New England by Brits in 1620 all the way up to the present.
So what did your research involve in putting this project together, Mr. Cox? Was there a lot of, you know, pie eating going on and sampling?
Well, yes, indeed. We did, my wife and I did what we call the Tour de Pie. Okay. And we tried to hit up every region in New England that we could think of that might have a good pie or a distinctive pie, something unusual, or simply just a well-made pie of whatever kind. And some of it was random, driving by the roadside and seeing a stand on the side. We'd pull off and have whatever they had to eat. And oftentimes that was gastric distress, but it was really great. And I have a love affair also with the commercial pies, things like Table Talk and the what I call the gas station pies, the things you can pick up for a buck at a late night station or at a convenience store. And all of this was part of the so-called research. If there was real research involved other than just eating, it came down to looking through our cookbooks and other cookbooks that we don't have here at UMass to try to identify a bit about the culture of pie consumption and pie production in New England. And our cookbooks go back in these community cookbooks to the 1860s, and we have other cookbooks that go back another 70 years or so before that. So we have a very wide field to work from in terms of literary sources or historic sources to work with when it comes to pie. And then you're always looking at novels and diaries and letters and people talking about pie. So the research is a combination of looking at contemporary pie and then looking at historic sources to extract pie.
Okay, so how is the book organized, or is it a history? Is it recipes? Is it personal stories? You know, how does the book flow?
It's actually, oddly enough, a bit of all three.
Okay.
When I started the book, I sat down first and said, you know, as a non-New Englander, for me, what are the most New England pies? What are the pies that tell you the most about who New Englanders are and about what New England cuisine is all about? And I made a list, and my list started getting longer and longer and longer because there's a lot of pies that are eaten in New England.
Sure.
And then I decided I had to boil it down somehow. And I came up with the idea of writing about one pie or one set of pies for each month of the year.
Oh, okay.
And, you know, what would be the right pie to talk about in August? Well, you know, blueberries come ripe in August to me. So that became the blueberry month. Apples became October. Pumpkin pie in November. And, you know, when you write about pumpkin pie, you can write about squash pie. Mm-hmm. So I used the year as the framework and told stories about the history of those pies for that month or about ideas that those pies represent. And at the end of every chapter, I included three, sometimes four or so historic recipes for pie. And there were one or two months where I took contemporary recipes as well from people I know who are very good pie cooks. And I threw them in because they're friends and they're good recipes.
Okay.
But you can't do a book about food without having some kind of recipe.
Sure. So what is kind of your hope for this project, the goal? You know, what is it that you hope folks will take away from it?
I think with all of these food projects, and pie especially, it's been to tell a story about what New England is, who we are as a group of people, as a culture. And food is really one of those elements of culture that is very deeply rooted. People hold food very close to them. You talk to people who are second, third, fourth generation beyond the point of immigration, and you'll often find that they eat the parents' or grandparents' foods at home,
yep,
even still. So in Michigan, when I lived there, I had a number of friends who were third or fourth generation Greek immigrants, and yet they would still eat lamb for Easter. They would still eat what they identified as Greek foods. And the little local church in East Hampton where I live now is a combination of Polish, Irish, and French parishes that were combined. And every year they have a festival. And at that festival, the French bring French meat pie. The Poles bring pierogi and other kinds of things. And the Irish don't show up at all. But anyway, there's a lot of foods that people hold on to. And I figured that food is a great way to talk about New England.
Okay. How long is the book? And are there any photographs in the book?
There are a lot of photos. It's not a terribly long book. It's maybe 150 pages, 120 pages, something in that range. And there are a lot of photographs that we took of pie and places where pie is made. And very interested in the process of cooking, even though I am absolutely, completely incompetent when it comes to cooking. I really just couldn't cook for my life. I can open a can, but I can't do much better than that. And so what I could do is when very good cooks are making pie, I could take good photos. And so we have historic photos, we have contemporary photos of pie being made, and the book is designed to give you a little bit of a visual sense of the food as well as a little bit of a historical sense.
Okay, so if you could talk about your presentation here at the library. Again, it's Tuesday, May 8th from 7 to 8:30 p.m. What'll be happening, and will we be eating any pie that night?
Well, I heard rumors that pie would be there. I myself, if I brought pie, it would be table talk pie, and you can get that cheaply enough at your local gas station.
Okay.
But for me, what I'll be doing is talking about some of my favorite pies and about some of the ideas that I've had coming out of reading about pies in New England. This idea, this question of why it is that New Englanders hold very dear to them. These things that I call false pies, these things that are called pies but are not actually pies.
Uh-huh.
And I'll take off from there a little bit. I don't want to give too much away up front, but that's one of the surprises for me when I started the book was I thought I would be talking about apple pie and pumpkin pie and peach pie, things like that. But in fact, a lot of these things that came onto the radar for me or onto the month-by-month mm-hmm. calendar anyway turn out to be things that are called pies that are very important in New England, but that are not even close to being pies.
I'm guessing Boston cream pies. What's on your mind right now?
There's one of the biggest culprits right there.
Okay.
It's the official state pie of Massachusetts, and it is not, I will repeat, not a pie.
Oh, the scandal. Well, we really look forward to your presentation. It sounds like an awful lot of fun. It sounds very interesting for folks maybe who are interested in certainly history of food but or pies in general. So thanks for spending some time with us today to talk about it.
Well, thank you for having me, and I look forward to seeing you guys on the 8th.
Again, that is Discover Historic New England series, The New England Pie, History Under a Crust by author Robert Cox, Tuesday, May 8th from 7 to 8:30 p.m. To learn more about this or any other programs at the library, go to their website, thomascranelibrary.org.